Hey everyone, it's Cooking with Anto. I know it's been a while, but a new video coming up here, as you can see in a moment. Chocolate crepes with Nutella and fresh strawberries with some whipped topping and a fresh strawberry on top and some chocolate syrup. This is simple, delicious, and you more than likely have most of these ingredients already at home. They're staple ingredients. Let's get started. I'm going to put some salt in a bowl and then I'm going to put in some flour. Okay, all the ingredients and the amounts that you need are always listed at the bottom of my videos. So now I'm going to put in some cocoa powder. Try your best to use a good quality cocoa powder, because we are telling people that we're going to serve them chocolate crepes. You really want it to taste like chocolate. Sometimes the lower quality cocoa powders can give a little bit of a dry texture. Think too much cinnamon. Okay, so go for a good quality cocoa powder if you can. If you don't have it available, then just use what you have available. So you're going to mix the dry ingredients and combine them together. And you're doing this because obviously you want everything mixed up before you start including your wet ingredients, right? That's simple. So the wet ingredients is a small list. First, I'm going to do a teaspoon of espresso. I know a lot of people don't drink espresso, use coffee. But for some reason, for me, espresso brings out the delicious flavor of chocolate, okay? So it's important and imperative when you're making something with chocolate to include either espresso or coffee. So now I've added in my milk. Normally, if I'm making a crepe that's gonna have a savory flavor to it, I'm gonna use half milk, half water, but for something that I want to be really rich, dessert-like, I'm using a full cup of milk. Now I'm adding in my eggs. And again, like I said earlier, all ingredients and the amounts you need are always at the bottom of my video. Click the down arrow, you'll see it, okay? So now I'm gonna combine the wet ingredients with the dry ingredients. I'm just going to mix it. And a lot of people think of batters like pancake batters, thick, lumpy. That's not what a crepe batter is. A crepe batter is extremely thin, almost water-like. There's no lumps in it, just gonna keep mixing. And I know you think when you're mixing that you're done, you're not. Just keep going until you can't see any lumps, because crepes are supposed to be generally almost paper thin, because you're gonna roll them. And if you're rolling something that's thick, it's gonna become too bulky and the texture is just going, you know, it won't be as delicious. You want a really thin batter. Also because of the way you're going to put it into the pan. If it's too thick, it's not going to roll around and create a perfect circle. You'll see what I mean in a minute. So you see how thin it is? That's how thin it's supposed to be. All right, so now I forgot, you know, I had made a couple before. I forgot that I wasn't recording. So here I am. I believe this is about the fourth or fifth one that I've made. So I'm using melted butter and then I slowly put in just a little bit. Okay. And I know you think that's a tiny crepe, but what you're going to do is you're going to take your pan and you're just going to kind of roll it around counterclockwise and get the batter that's on the top of the crepe to move over and create a bigger circle. I hope that's making sense. Unfortunately, while I was recording, I didn't realize I was in the best angle. So there's your crepe, okay? Don't touch it anymore. Don't roll it around. As you can see, because this is real time right now, you see the little bubbles popping up at the top. When your edges begin to get darker and more dry, that's when you know your process is going. As you can see, there's like a ring going around. And you're going to wait till like the middle of the crepe looks a little more dry. And that's when you flip it, because you want the cooking process to be done mostly now. Because when you flip it, you don't want to brown that side too much, because that's the side people are going to see. And you don't want, you know, those brown marks. You'll see in a minute when I flip it what I'm talking about. Do you see what I'm saying? So if you cooked it too much on the other side, when you roll it, it's not going to look as appetizing. So you're going to get most of the process cooked on the first step. Now you're going to take your filling. Me, I'm using Nutella. Okay, and then I'm going to put some fresh strawberries. So what I do is I cut my strawberries into little pieces, okay? And my secret is that I put a sprinkle of granulated sugar on them to get them to be really juicy. As you can see, look at how nice that looks. So you just put a little strawberry in. And for these particular crepes, I'm going to go with the rolling method as opposed to the burrito kind of look, like that triangle that some crepes have, only because the filling here, because of the fresh strawberries. If it was just Nutella, we would roll them the more traditional way, okay? So I'm going to show you real quick the quick roll up. Really, it's nothing, you know, that requires a lot of experience. You're just rolling it up slowly, okay? I can show you, see? working it in the triangle is not going to work. So that's why you have to roll it this way. All right, because all the fruit would literally fall out if you tried to fold the crepe the other way. So now you can leave it seam side down, okay? You're gonna put some delicious chocolate syrup over it. There you go. You don't have to be as slow as me. I'm just, you know, it's the effect here I'm trying to give you. Then you're gonna put some whipped topping. Now, I used that whipped topping out of the can. I didn't have any heavy cream that I felt like whipping. So you can use that too, it's no big deal. So literally that's all you're doing, guys. You're putting that whipped topping on, fresh strawberry, that's it. Your crepes are done. Chocolate crepes with Nutella, strawberry filling with a fresh strawberry on top. It's literally that simple. This is probably the easiest dessert that you can serve people. And again, the importance behind using, if you can, one, the freshest ingredients, and two, the best quality that you have available in your home. Because when you're telling someone, I'm gonna give you a chocolate crepe with strawberries, you want them to taste all aspects of that. So use a good quality cocoa powder if you can. And don't forget to use melted butter with your crepes, not a pan spray, because melted butter, you're gonna get those layers of flavor when you bite into your dessert, all right? But that's it, guys. It was a simple, quick recipe. I know it's been quite a while since I've posted a video. Follow me on Facebook, facebook.com/cookingwithanto. And thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate you all. I miss you all. And in a few days, we'll have a new video. Take care, everyone. Stay safe and healthy.